loving you, Nascam.
Hello and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. If this is your first time, you are welcome to join the family. If you have been watching but you are still contemplating, should I subscribe or not? What are you waiting for, guys? Please click the subscribe button down below and don't forget to turn on that notification. It's for you to get notified whenever I upload any video, and I appreciate all your support, everyone that have subscribed. Today I'm going to quickly talk about this woman that has been used by several pastors to perform miracle or just bust my woman in Lara men. While I was doing my own research about what is going on, I came across an interview done with this woman, and it was posted on Facebook. I'm going to try and put the excerpts of this interview on the screen right here, but I'm going to read a little bit of that interview for you guys. I don't want this video to be too long. I just really have something to say about this. They ask her, how come you attend several churches where you claimed you have been healed or same ailment? And this woman answered, truly, whenever I attend such churches, I get healed, but ailment relapse after 2 days. And they ask her, relapse every 2 days? What exactly do you mean by that? And she answered and said, once they heal me, I feel no pains, but after 2 days, the pains returns. The reason I continue visiting different churches for a permanent healing. And they asked her, how many churches have you visited so far? This woman said she can't actually recollect how many churches she has visited. And they asked her, if anybody linked her with all these churches she has visited, or even the last churches she visited, Prophet Chris Okafor of Liberation Ministry, and what has been the experience so far. And she said her sister-in-law introduced her to that church.
What is your name again?
My name is Bosale.
Okay, welcome to CKN. Now, when did you get the accident that caused
the accident? Around 2 years now.
About 2 years.
Yes.
Is it motor accident, Okada accident, or which kind of accident?
I just fell down.
You fell down?
Yes.
In the house?
Mm.
And okay. Yes. Can you remember how many churches you have gone to heal this hand?
I've gone to many churches. I've read the
tape. Okay.
Yes. I go to many churches.
Okay.
They will heal me.
They will heal you.
Yes, now.
Then after healing you, 2 days.
Yes.
It will come back again.
Yes, now. Then try their best.
Okay.
They heal me.
Okay.
So after 2 days, I want to come back.
Mm.
And I don't know what to do. That's why I told my husband's sister.
Mm.
Tell you the response of this woman, because sometimes when we see news, the news go mainstream, we don't know whether this is true or this is not true, but this is this woman denying it. What I want to say about this is that with the way she conducted the interview, it looks convincing that this woman is not lying. But at the same time, if you think deeply, like somebody that can think outside the box or think with their own mind and nobody thinking for you, it looks like this woman is just securing back. Like, these people are giving her money. Because see, a lot of people are not interested in all these fake miracles, because we've seen so much. People have seen just too much, and they are tired of all these false and fake miracle. So when this thing came out, people just run with the narratives that this woman is being used by all these pastors to fake miracles so that people can come to their churches. I will just advise people, stop looking around for any miracle. Every miracle you want is in the Bible. Read your Bible. There is always solution and answer for every problem you have in the Bible. If truly this woman is securing bad with all this fake and false miracle, she is actually incurring curse into her life. She's calling the curses and she won't be healed. That's one thing. If truly she's feeling pains and everything, and these people are offering her money for her to do this thing, it's not worth it, because where is her healing when she continues to do this? And more so, if she is truly collecting money because of this thing, how do you think she's going to get ill eventually? No, because you can ever deceive God. You can deceive man, you can deceive everybody, but you can never deceive God. It's only the one that sees the heart of each and every one of us and can judge us. I want to say again that If this woman is not doing it for money, or she's not doing it just to secure a bag and get money that is not going to take her anywhere, I just pray that God is going to touch her and heal her entirely of all these diseases and sicknesses and ailments that might be on her body. Because, to be honest, when I saw this interview, I'm confused as to what to believe. But I want to leave it to you guys. Do you believe this woman is actually doing it to collect money, securing back from all these pastors and using herself as a specimen for fake miracles? Or do you think the interview she did was actually true, that this woman is genuinely looking for healing and she's not doing it because of the money? I just want to hear all your thoughts and opinion in the comment section down below, because it's actually beyond me. You know, they said she did this, she said she didn't do it. I want to hear what you guys think about this. Let's continue the discussion in the comment section down below. And on your way out, don't forget to give this video a like, and remember, subscribe and turn on that notification bell so that you can get notified whenever I upload a video. I will see you in the next one. Bye.